Very well will be, John. It's a strong wind. Looked like it might rain earlier, but I think it's clearing up now. So, but it certainly will affect the kicking game and the passing game, too.
Tennessee against Memphis State. And Memphis State, Bill, let's start talking about Memphis State. And I think we would start with that very powerful defensive line.
Well, I think that's the strong point of the Memphis State team is the defensive line. John, they're very active, big, strong, and if you're not careful, they can cause you an awful lot of problems.
Some names of outstanding players like Harris and Fair and Octavian Sharp and Borky, a big, strong, a team that has been tough to run against, and certainly Tennessee will have its work cut out for it.
I think that's very true, and if they can't, Tennessee's going to have to throw the ball, win or no win, to loosen them up a little bit, or it'll be a very tough afternoon.
Starting for Tennessee at quarterback will be Darryl Dickey, who will be making his third start of the year. And against Rutgers, of course, Bill, Darryl Dickey moved the team pretty well.
He played very well, and I think he's gotten some confidence now. I think it wasn't all Darryl's problem, I don't think, John, against the Georgia Tech. He didn't play that well in that game, but I think maybe it was the way they were trying to do things with Darryl and a little let down after losing Robinson. But he's a good athlete and a heady kid, and he played very well against Rutgers, and I think he'll continue to play well.
This will be tough for both teams.
No question. This is always the team, you know. Memphis State doesn't have that good a record, but it's the kind of team you got to be very careful with. Give them a little momentum, and you got a long afternoon.
Well, we're going to be watching this football game with you, and we hope that you'll enjoy it. It will be Tennessee against Memphis State in Memphis, and it will be coming up your way. As we say, we'll be back with the opening State, and Carlos Hervéz will begin this kick, this game with the kickoff as Memphis State wins the opening toss. Keep in mind that Tennessee has a strong wind at its back. Grass surface, first time Tennessee, well, the wind right there makes itself evident as the ball is blown off the tee. This is the first time Tennessee has played on natural or grass surface this year. Carlos Hervéz to kick off. Deep will be Harris for Memphis State, and this game is underway. And it will be Harris making the catch and stepping out of bounds right there, actually downing the ball for the touchback. And so Memphis State goes on offense. The quarterback will be Sparkman. His running backs, Womack. And this is Womack through the left side of the line, and he picks up a couple of yards on the play. Moody is the fullback, Sparkman the quarterback, Ferris a wide out. Womack from McMinnville, Tennessee. Game just getting underway at Memphis. Overcast, some threat of rain, but really doesn't feel like it's going to rain. This is Sparkman to throw. To run. And that's Brown and Cooper in the cover him. Danny Sparkman this year for Memphis State has completed 118 of 228 passes.
Now Sparkman's just coming out on the swing pass. A good job downfield. Obviously, he can't find anybody to throw it to, and there comes Big Cooper across to trip him up.
Another look at the pressure from Richard Brown, a senior from Riviera Beach, Florida, 98 and 77. Cooper, who's from Memphis, Tennessee. Robbie Scott, out with an injury for Tennessee, is on the trip. And Bennett, the middle guard, Fred Bennett, is not on the trip. And carrying the ball through the left side, Memphis State is short. And there you see Darren Miller, linebacker, on the stop. Fourth down upcoming. A lot of orange in Memphis, as big orange fans from throughout West Tennessee and Shelby County are joined by Tennesseans from throughout the state. As Memphis State will be punished. Deep for Tennessee, Kramer. Punt into the wind, and it's a stiff wind. And Kramer's racing up, dive, fumbles the football, recovered, I think, by Tennessee. That wind is a factor, Bill.
Yeah, that hangs the ball up there. He misjudged it. Of course, he hit it up there. He's playing it to come back deeper, and the ball just kind of hangs. And you'll see him break for it to try to go up and get to it. And at the last minute, he has to dive out for it. He misjudged it a little bit there, and he gets away from him. Almost a big play for State.
But it is a big play for Tennessee's Chris White with the interception. And so Tennessee will go on offense first down in a nothing-nothing game. That's Darryl Dickey behind Todd Kirk, Galbreath and Bruin, the guards. Here is up the middle for Tennessee, the fullback Howard, churning in the middle for a gain of four. Now for Memphis State defensively, It will be Brandon, Borky, McKay, Dean, Harris up front, Sharp and Fears the linebackers, Hunt and Hughes, Hooper and Palmer deep. Dickey with Davis and Howard, the running back. Davis, fumble ball. I think Davis recovered it.
Got back on it.
Tennessee, three times handling the ball and two fumbles.
Oh, that's almost another big break for State here. Of course, the pitch is good. Davis just can't handle the ball, but alertly he gets back on it and saves the ball.
Third down, a loss on the play of right at 6 yards. And so on third down, Dickey fakes the throw. Setting up. The pass is incomplete. Intended for McGee. Overthrown, incomplete, fourth down, and momentum all important as Memphis State has stopped Tennessee. And so in the punt for the Vols will be Bob Garman. Deep again will be Harris. Garman hits it. That's Harris watching it bounce, picks it up, will return the ball. Gets to the outside, spins, fumble, scramble, let's see. It's recovered by Tennessee. The fumble by Harris is recovered by Brian Kimbrough. And Tennessee gets a turnover. Both punts, one by Tennessee, one by Memphis State. Fumble. Tennessee recovered it. Memphis State has lost it. And so Tennessee has it first down and 10 at the 16. And as Memphis State is jumping around on defense, Tennessee uses a timeout.
Right, here's the second look. I think maybe we can pick up the shot. It comes in. There it is, from the backside, knocking the ball loose. Good leg.
So Tennessee will now have the football. It's nothing to nothing. The ball is at the 16-yard line of Memphis State. First quarter, Tennessee threatening after the turnover. That's Keith Davis. And he is racked up and hit hard as he gets the ball down to the 10-yard line. And Davis is hurt.
Well, he gets a pretty good hole here. The lineman opened up a pretty good hole for him. Keith standing straight up, and there comes a tough shot right into the shoulder from the backside.
And Davis, who sat out much of the game with Rutgers in the second half with an injury, let's see if we can check it right here. And you can see that he is blasted. This will be a hard-hitting football game.
No question. I think there's going to be a lot of licks passed before the day's over, John. Of course, Davis didn't see the man coming at him. It looks like it hit him right on that bad shoulder.
Second down for Tennessee. Nothing at the 10-yard line of the Tigers. Henderson. Good effort, Henderson. He was pretty well bogged down in the center of the line. It just sort of spins off, as you see, and gets it down. It will not be a first down. Third down, Tennessee. Nothing to score. At the 7. Wilson. I think he got it. Charles Wilson sweeps the right side. And it will be first down and goal to go for Tennessee. A second look.
Well, he's getting a good block. That's just a sweep. He's got the power block out there with his fullback. Makes a good block. Just enough to pick up the first down. That's really all they were after.
So it's Tennessee first down and goal at the Memphis State 5. First quarter, nothing to score. Dickey. Carrying the ball is Powell. Jeff Powell is in a tailback. And he knifes over right guard for a couple of yards down to the 3.
Big, strong defensive punt there by Memphis State, John. They're hard to move the ball in these short yardage situations. Hard to move against them.
Tennessee, second and goal at the 3. Wilson. Oh, that will be Tim Harris defensively, penetrating and throwing him for a loss. Big play, State. There's an outstanding football player, 6'7".
No question about that. And he comes across there, just gets right through. Nobody, doesn't look like anybody even blocking those gun, but he's there. Wilson had no place at all to go.
And it's a loss. Third down, still goal to go for Tennessee in a nothing game. Third down. T. Jeff Smith out to the left. Dickey back to throw. After him, that was Harris. The pass is, let's see, incomplete. Trapped on a possible interception. It was intended for Clink Scales, doubled up, so he could not get to the football. And here's Carlos Reves to attempt the field goal. It is up. It is good.
That's a good stand by Memphis State. He had to hold him off for a field goal down there. He
has taken the kickoff, and the Tigers have moved downfield, and there's the ball at the Tennessee 12-yard line. It will be third down and three, Memphis State. The Tigers moving with the ball. Sparkman, the quarterback, back to throw. Danny Sparkman is deflected and intercepted.
Well, what a big play this is. Knocks it way up in the air and it's picked it off.
The interception by Ziegler as Sparkman on third and three was throwing, and one of the linemen for Tennessee got his hands up. Let's see if we can pick it out. 77 is Cooper, but it was not he. Instead, one of the out might have been Dale Jones. Anyway, there's Ziegler with an over-the-shoulder catch, and Tennessee has the ball.
He looks like a wide out here. He makes a nice catch.
Kelly Ziegler with the interception, and State has been stopped in Tennessee's dickey. Gives it off to the tailback into the football game, and that will be Charles Wilson, who has come on for the injured Keith Davis.
Well, it's just a handoff off tackle, try to find the daylight. Wilson does a good job in there, picking up some extra yardage.
Tennessee, of course, up front with Smith, Galbraith, Kurt, Bruin, Wilkerson, Dickey the quarterback, Charles Wilson the tailback, Howard and Henderson alternating at fullback, 3-0 Tennessee leading, first quarter. And there you see Memphis State just jumping around on defense as Dickey tries to check off. Dickey blasted as he throws, incomplete, skipping toward McGee, double covered. The pass is incomplete. Terrell Hooper, number 11, from Jackson, Tennessee, played quarterback as a starting quarterback for an entire season at Memphis State, now shifted to defense. Outstanding free safety. Third down for the Vols. Carrying forward, that will be Jeff Powell. And Powell at the left side might have gotten enough for the first. He's come on for Charles Wilson, who's been injured. Here's the pitch, and here's Bill Anderson.
Well, it's one of the basic plays. Of course, State up front, they're really tough and active, moving around there, and he picked up about a yard, I believe.
Tennessee will have a first down, leading by a score of 3-0. Dickey, Powell. It is tough inside. Memphis State defensively with Eric Fairs, the linebacker, leading his team in stops this year, 108. Jeff Powell, a walk-on. Actually, not a walk-on. He's on a track scholarship. So that becomes a football scholarship. And this will be Tennessee's Darrell Dickey. There you see. It looks to me they're reading Tennessee's audible.
They're doing a lot of adjusting when Darrell tries the audible, I'll tell you that.
In trouble, Dickey is going to run, and Dickey is blasted, and it is ruled that he is down. That ball comes free, and Memphis State thinks it has a recovered fumble, but Dickey was down, and so Tennessee maintains possession. It is not enough for the first down, a second look.
Darrell can't find anybody to throw, of course, has to come out of the pocket here. Now he's pumping, trying to hold him off a little bit, but he comes up in there, and the ball is... very close, John.
Maybe. Third down and three. Tennessee maintaining possession. And this is Darrell Dickey. Pass almost intercepted. Memphis State. And there you see the man, Brandon, who had it.
Yeah, he had it for a moment. He was in perfect position.
Tennessee unable to pick up another first down. The Vols have two in the game. Memphis State to this point has three, but Tennessee leads 3-0. And this will be blocked. The punt is blocked. And picking up Harkins, and Memphis State has the lead. how suddenly it changes. The punt cleanly blocked by Memphis State. And Harkins picked it up and scampers untouched in for the touchdown. Another look. Garmin.
You can see the blue shirts there. He is, makes it a very clean block, but there's two or three blue shirts coming through that probably could have blocked it. Big play. That can turn the ball game around and very quickly.
It is a touchdown for Memphis State. And suddenly the score is Memphis State 6, Tennessee 3. Into attempt, the extra point will be Ingles. It's up, and it is good. That's the end of the first quarter with the score. Tennessee trails Memphis State 7-3, but the Volunteers have it. As you see, third down, and this Memphis State defense is absolutely controlling the game at this point. Darrell Dickey at quarterback. Back to throw. Nice protection. Pass. Complete. Just missed. 35, 40, 45. Knocked out of bounds in Memphis State territory. Big play. Dickey to Jeff Smith, senior tight end, Milan, Tennessee.
Dickey gets good time. Good protection. Down the offensive line. Looking for one to go downfield. Looks like State's defensive secondary probably made a mistake because Smith's standing over there all by himself. He picks him up and gets the ball to him.
And so Tennessee on a pass play that's good for 30 yards. And the Volunteers will have it first down, trailing 7-3. Second quarter just getting underway. Through the right side, that's Keith Davis back into action. And he gets, about a yard, maybe two on the play.
Play number 73, Mike McKay.
Davis went out earlier with that injured shoulder, has returned to service as Wilson, too, has been hurt. And Jeff Powell is back in there now at tailback. Second down, Tennessee. Dickey setting up, looking, waiting, throwing. Complete, Howard, 45. Howard, first down to the 35 and beyond. William Howard, Lima, Ohio, with the reception.
It looks like he wants to go downfield here. Must be the receivers are covered. He's got Howard on the secondary receiver. He flips it out there to him, and Howard does a strong running right there. Breaks the tackle and picks up some nice yardage off of a very short pass.
13 yards on the play as Howard makes the catch, and Tennessee will have it first down at the 34-yard line of State, trailing 7-3. The Tigers on top. Delay, Powell breaking it. This is Jeff Powell fighting his way for yardage. Roll down again. Memphis State pouncing on a ball, but Powell was ruled down on the play. A gain of 11 yards by the senior.
Let's just get running by Powell here, John. There's not a whole lot of running room there. He breaks the tackle right about the line of scrimmage, and then there's another one being missed, and just pushes it forward downfield. Good running.
A third look from the end zone.
That's the big break right there. Gives him a little running room, and then that one doesn't quite get to him, and he takes a pretty good shot there as he goes down.
From Terrell Hooper, but Tennessee has another first down, trailing 7-3. Howard, he's banged in the middle. As Memphis State stops, Sharp was there. Thayers was there, number 98, senior. Thayers and Harris, both seniors. And second down nine, Tennessee in Memphis State territory, trailing 7-3. Dickey shouting out the call. Powell racked up, not much there this time.
A little bit of a draw play. It's hard running inside against this State down lineman. They are tough.
Eric Fears, number 98, the linebacker, pounding Powell down. And Tennessee is faced with a third down. 7-3, State leads. Tennessee threatening. Dickey with the ball at the 19. Back to throw. Sets up. Pass. Give him six. Touchdown, Tim McGee.
Put it up on the backboard. He came in on the post route. Offensive line does their job, gives him time to throw the ball, and he puts it right on the money. Nice play.
Tim McGee, sure-handed receiver, leading receiver for Tennessee. And that's his fourth touchdown catch of the year. As Bill Anderson outlined for you, perfectly executed, and Tennessee has a two-point lead as Carlos Reves will be coming on to attempt the extra point. Sanders holds. The kick is up, and it splits them. Tennessee leads Memphis State by a score of 10-7. And the orange and white Shakers. As we look once more, Bill Anderson, at a perfect strike for six.
Yeah, that's a thing of beauty right in there, right on target. Nice catch by McGee. Beat his man to the inside on the post route.
So Tennessee has grabbed the lead. And it's now Tennessee 10, Memphis State 7, and Carlos Reves will be, doesn't hit it well at all, and it's taken by an up receiver, and Memphis State immediately has excellent field position. The wind, we keep repeating it, the wind a factor, but perhaps there, Bill, more a factor mentally for Reves.
Well, it might be. I don't think the ball moved, but he missed that one.
So, here's Memphis State. Sparkman. Womack, look at him go. Womack with the football, caught from behind by Ziegler. Great running by Womack.
State has some good athletes. Womack is a fine runner, Johnny. They do a good job opening a little crack over there off the right side. A big offensive line, but there again, there's some missed tackles. He breaks the tackles, comes here, and he pops it loose. That's to be dug down from behind.
And it is a gain of 21 yards to the Volunteer 43-yard line, where it's first down State. Tennessee 10, Memphis State 7. Womack slips and falls. As he was making his cut to the inside, a loss of two. Second down, 13.
I don't think he would have gotten much on that one anyway. Tennessee had him very well. Everybody was in good shape.
Sparkman, the choir of the Southland band forming the backdrop as Sparkman sets up. Running. Slides into second base. That was maintained there by Brown of Tennessee. Sparkman from Collierville, Tennessee, a senior, record-setting passer at Memphis State, and he is tough.
He's one to throw deep to Harris, I think, down on the route. He couldn't. Tennessee had him covered. He pulled it down, and right there, he takes a good shot. He is a tough man.
Third down, Memphis State. Sparkman wants to throw. The pass is dropped. Intended for Moody at the 27-yard line, and he could not hold on. So fourth down is coming up with Tennessee leading, and Memphis State is going to try a long, long field goal. Here it is. No. Very short. And so there's time out on the field of play with the score, Tennessee 10, Memphis State 7. On offense, the Volunteers leading by a score of 10-7. This will be third down and two at the Volunteer 19 as we pick up the action. Memphis State's defense, very stingy, very physical. Dickey to throw. Pass is complete. That's Clint Scales breaking it, carrying the ball out to the 44-yard line, and that will be enough for the first down.
State's defense jumping around a lot, John. The bringing defensive backs up on the line of scrimmage. Everybody jumping around, and the way Tennessee's going to attack that is just hit the quick pass. They hit it in there to Clink Scales, and he makes a nice move. He's got a lot of running room.
Memphis State actually deployed initially all 11 men on the line of scrimmage, much like was true in the game in Knoxville last year. And Tennessee reacts, getting the ball out. Here's Memphis State shifting. There you see Harris moving over. That defense always moving. Dickey, play action, rolling left, pass, complete, 50. Good hit by Brandon. William Howard with the catch.
Nice catch by Howard. He probably would have been a little better off. I think he would have felt better if he had turned to the outside. He turns around and can't see this guy. The blue shirt pops him a good lick.
There's William Howard. And right there is Hooper, right, but from the other side, yes. That's Brandon. Gain on the play, however. Tennessee leading by a score of 10-7. In motion is Powell. Howard crashes through the left side of the line.
It's getting awful sticky inside there, John. Not a whole lot of running room.
Cross in on the stop. 10-7 Tennessee, the Volunteers with the ball in Memphis State territory. It's first down and 10 to go, as that was Howard picking up the first down on the play. Powell, staggering forward, lost his balance slightly. Pretty well covered, but he had a big hole, Bill Anderson.
That's a little bit of a draw, and of course he hits a little bit of a hole in there, but he's got his body lean so far forward that he can't get his balance back up. He tripped up a little bit there, right about the line of scrimmage.
But it is a gain on the play by Jeff Powell. As Tennessee continues to move in a 10-7 game, the Volunteers leading. Powell that time picks up 8 yards. Dickey. Complete. Jeff Smith.
Go to the tight end a whole lot. They come off of the play action here, and he's wide open coming down the middle.
Again, Memphis State jumping into that unorthodox defense. And Dickey looking for the tight end from Milan, Tennessee, and that's Jeff Smith, his second big catch of the game. This one good for 25 yards, and Tennessee will have it at the 12-yard line.
State plays a very unusual defense through this on these last few plays, last series.
Carrying the ball right side, being knocked down is Powell. He carried from the 12 to the 9. Gain of 3. Second down and 7 to go for the first down. Kirk, the man injured on the play, you caught a glimpse of him. Tennessee is really plagued with injuries. And there's a big Orange fan budding. And he'll mature in about 15 years and might be a running back. Who knows? Darrell Dickey sizing up the defense, and there Fairs just relays Dickey's call to his teammates. Dickey back to throw. Waiting. Passing. Touchdown! 6 points, Eric Swanson.
Excellent catch there by Swanson. Maybe we get a rerun of this. John, of course, Dickey just stands up again and hits him. Coming in pretty much similar to the McGee touchdown. Hits him on the post, coming inside on the quick shot. But there's a great catch. See, Swanson had to turn around, reach back, and actually took the ball away from the state defender.
Eric Swanson, senior, San Bernardino, California, with the catch. And Tennessee builds the lead. And in will be Reves, trying to make it a 10-point differential. You can judge for yourself, and you can see that it's good, and so Tennessee leads by a score of 17-7. And Tennessee has pretty well controlled the second quarter of the game. 7-3 at the quarter. Now Tennessee trying for a 10-point lead, and there you see just a great effort by Eric Swanson.
Well, he held himself in the open spot there, and Eric's not too happy with it. Lick he got there, I guess, after the ball, after he caught the TD.
But the touchdown stands. The extra point makes it Tennessee 17, Memphis State 7. The wind continues to blow, and Carlos Reves will be kicking into the teeth of the wind, judged 15 to 20 miles per hour. Now, again, you see it fall off. Tennessee could ask for one of the members of the team to hold the ball, but not so.
Yeah, that much wind, it can really affect the kicking game and the passing game. You don't realize how strong it is, but it's very strong up high when it's blowing the ball off of the tee.
Harris with the ball back outside the 20 to the 24-yard line, and Memphis State will have the ball trailing by 10 points, 17-7, first down. Sparkman has gone all the way at quarterback. Defensively, Tennessee going with outside linebackers Brian Kimbrough and Jones, Cooper and Hovannik, Brown. That's Richard. As you see, the return here by Harris. Linebackers Ziegler and Miller. Cornerbacks Kramer, Brown, Terry Brown, Charles Davis, Tommy Sims, Chris White, of course, also in there for Tennessee from time to time. Sparkman passing complete. And as the catch was made by Martin, his knee was on the ground. Gain of five. Second down and five. Chelsea leads by 10 points, 17-7, nearing the end of the first half. Barkman sacked. Dale Jones.
Good pressure. Dale comes from the backside. Sparkman never saw him coming. Covers him up.
A second look at big play Dale Jones, Jr., Cleveland, Tennessee.
Dale's made a lot of big plays this season, John. He's really become a fine linebacker.
And so Sparkman is sacked as the first half comes to a close. That's the end of the first half with the score, Tennessee 17, Memphis State. Tennessee leads Memphis State by a score of 17-7. Third quarter getting underway as the Tigers have the football. And this is Sparkman. Third down play, back to throw. Being pressured out of the pocket. Looking, throwing. It is incomplete. Intended for Lovelady and simply could not hold on.
Well, they've dropped balls on Sparkman all day. That's about the second or third, the third time that he's had the ball. He's trying, wants to go downfield. He does a good job of getting out of the pocket here. And he's got his man wide open and delivers it. Ball should have been caught, but he just can't hold on to it.
Kramer was there defending, but Lovelady couldn't find the handle, and so it will be third down. That was the second down play. Sparkman, long pass this time thrown over the head of Moody, the intended receiver. Tennessee had him doubled anyway, so it will be fourth down, and Memphis State is going to attempt a field goal. Glosson will attempt a 51-yard field goal. There it is. It's long enough, but it is no good. Off to the left, as you see. And so Tennessee will get the ball at the point of the kick attempt, and this will be Darryl Dickey at quarterback. The Volunteers clinging to a 17-7 lead, but the Vols have been unable to do much here in the third quarter. Dickey, blitz. Oh, he is sacked. Here from the outside comes the linebacker. That's David Brandon. And Dickey is snowed under for minus 12. Tennessee in the second half. Minus yardage.
Well, when they come on the blitz, they can put a lot of heat on. They've got some strong people up front that time. They just didn't pick him up, Brandon, from the outside.
It was Fairs blitzing up the middle. And Dickey looking at him. And all of a sudden, there was Brandon from the outside. 17-7 Tennessee. Second down, 22, and struggling for the gain of 5 yards. That's Howard. Five carries, 13 yards for him. And for Tennessee, it will be third down and 17 yards to go at the Liberty Bowl Memorial Stadium. Tennessee with two long touchdown drives against that gambling Memphis State defense in the second quarter, leading by 10 points, 17-7. Darryl Dickey sacked again.
Came from the other side that time, John. No chance. Darryl didn't have time to get set, so he had the man right down his back.
That's Marlon Brown. Just great physical specimen for this Memphis State team, defensively particularly.
Yeah, they do. They really come, and they can put a lot of heat on a quarterback, and very tough against the run. Great athletes up front. They have size and quickness and a whole lot of strength.
So here's Bob Garman into punt. Gets it away, and this will be Harris. Under the ball. Fumble! I think Tennessee's got the ball. Joel Farmer, who snaps on punt. Downfield, Harris just lost it, and Farmer found it.
There again, I think the wind's a factor, John. He misjudged that. Of course, he had that one pretty well in hand, but he just couldn't hold on there. He might have misjudged it a little bit. But that ball hangs, and it'll do some crazy things sometime when it comes down in that strong wind like we got here this afternoon.
And Joel Farmer has the football, and Tennessee, with a big, big turnover, has first down. You see the ball is just on the Memphis State side of midfield. At the 49. Powell. Ooh. Oh. Another loss for Tennessee. A loss of a yard on the play. In the last four plays, not including that punt, Tennessee has lost net 15 yards. But Tennessee picked up about 42 yards on the recovered fumble of the punt. Tennessee 17, Memphis State 7, third quarter. Carries 49 yards with that 9-yard pickup, and now Tennessee has a third tailback injury. Jeff Powell.
Powell has a pretty good hold here. He gets it turned up the field, John. It breaks his tackle again there, but he's kind of stumbling. It almost cuts a flip and comes down. I think he hurt himself more than the lick from the State defender. He came down on his head and shoulder.
Although the defender from Memphis State on the play really put a stick in there, that being number 26, Ron Palmer. Tennessee with the ball. This will be third down. Dickey, Howard, Fairs. Far short. And Tennessee still does not have a first down in the third quarter. First possession minus a yard. Second possession minus 14. Third possession plus 8. And a punt.
They gambled a lot in the first half. They've gone back to just basics to the five-man front and at times the four-man front. But they're playing their basic defense, and they're doing a much better job of stopping Tennessee.
So into punt will be Garmin. Hits it high, pooching it downfield. Tennessee racing after the ball. It will be no into the end zone for the touchback as Hendricks had his hand on the ball and simply could not keep it from breaking the play. So there's timeout on the field with a score in the third quarter. Tennessee 17, Memphis State. After an exchange of punts, Tennessee, faking the field goal, and this is Randy Sanders, the quarterback, to throw it into a crowd. Tennessee had two people there, Smith, and I believe the other might have been Howard coming out of the backfield, and Memphis State stops the drive, gets the ball after the incomplete pass. And here come the Tigers as Womack cracks up the middle for a gain of 9 yards. 13 carries, 68 yards for the McMinnville Jr. Danny Sparkman, his team trailing by 10, brings him to the line. It will be second down, a yard to go. And this will be a first down as Brown is in at fullback now for the Tigers. Gain of 4. And Memphis State has its 7th first down of the ballgame. Tennessee yet to pick up a first down in the second half. This is Brown. That's Darren Miller.
This is turning into a defensive struggle here in the second half, John. I think the wind's had a lot to do with the passing game. As a result, they're having to try to run, and neither team's been able to do much with it.
Womack jaunts forward for a gain of 5 yards. So it will be second down and 5. For Tennessee defending, number 33, Keith DeLong, freshman linebacker. And it will be second down and 5. Tennessee 17, Memphis State 7, third quarter at Memphis. Womack. Oh, he's got a first down. Blocking up front for Memphis State. A big, big forward wall. On the right side, that's Borgi, who is 312. Walker over there outstanding. Opening it up. Up front, it will be Thomas, Dill, East, Borgi, Walker. Quarterback Sparkman, running backs in the I formation. Womack. Womack, first down.
You know, State does have they have an awful lot of good athletes. A very big offensive line, a tremendous defensive front, and a huge offensive line. They have a good hole here. They have good running backs. They just, John, have had problems not making the big play when they need to or making the bad play at the wrong time because there are an awful lot of good athletes on this football team.
Womack comes out with the injury after picking up the first down, the 8th of the game for Memphis State, the 2nd in this drive, which began at the State 28-yard line. Cutting through the left side of the line this time comes Holmes. Gets 4 yards. I said 8. Memphis State has 9 first downs. That, of course, the 3rd in this drive, as you know. Moving into Tennessee territory, back to throw will be Sparkman. The pass is complete. Great effort. Sparkman completed to Lovelady down to the Tennessee 13-yard line.
Sparkman is a gutty quarterback. He's taking some real shots today, and I don't know whether we can get a very good shot over here, but he takes another good lick. He gets pushed out of the pocket on the rollout, and here he comes right there. Just as he delivers it, he takes a good solid lick, but he's got the ball right on target.
And the catch is made by Lovelady and spots the ball at the 10-yard line, just outside the 10, instead of the 13 as we originally had spotted it. Now, Memphis State can make a first down without scoring. So here's State trailing by 10, and Sparkman sees Tennessee adjust defensively, so he uses the timeout. Memphis State down to two timeouts left now in the second half. Tennessee's head coach, Johnny Majors, walking the sidelines as Memphis State trailing 17-7, first down, 10 to go, just outside the 10. Bang!
That's good defense there. They were right on target where they're supposed to be, not a yard. In fact, I think they threw him back for maybe a loss of a yard or so here.
You'll see the play. As Tennessee's Terry Brown was there, and right there is Darren Miller. As Memphis State running to the right side with Tracy Holmes, a loss. Second down, 12. Holmes ridden down from behind by Darren Miller.
Miller, Kimbrough. Miller's getting very active there. He comes all the way across from the back side to ride him down here. Gets it all the way. That's good for Stoop. That's the kind of thing that Coach Donahue likes. I know Johnny likes to see a lot of orange shirts arriving at the ball game.
55, not 45, and the tackle is for Tennessee, stopping Memphis State, but the third quarter is coming to a close. That is, in fact, the end of the third quarter with the score, Tennessee 17, Memphis. Picking up the action, Memphis State will have it third down. And 10 yards to go, trailing by a score of 17-7 as the fourth period finds the pass. It is incomplete. Harris, the intended receiver, defending was Kramer. And Memphis State, Bill, had a timeout left as that third quarter ticked away. Now the pass you see thrown into the wind. Kramer, stride for stride, reaches. Well, I don't know. It's incomplete.
Well, Harris is a little bit unhappy with this. Of course, that's the timing pattern, and it's difficult to time it. The ball kind of hangs up there in the air, but Kramer's over there on him and was able to pull his hand down. Really, it looked like Harris was going to come down with it.
The pass incomplete, and here's the field goal attempt into the wind, and it is no good. The field goal is no good. Ingles attempting a 23-yard field goal. It is wide, and Tennessee's defense stops Memphis State after State had engineered an excellent, excellent drive. So the Volunteers will get the ball after the missed field goal, moving it out to the 20-yard line. The score in the game, 17-7, and Tennessee has been absolutely stopped. Right there again. Memphis State, the pitch goes to Panuska, the fourth tailback to play for Tennessee in the game, and Jeff Ellis penetrates and stops him for a loss.
Well, he's got no place to go at all there. That's good defense, good penetration, and they've been in the second half a very stingy defensive unit, this State group.
Tennessee minus six. Second down, 16, deep in Tennessee territory at the 14. Dickey. Incomplete. So it'll be third down. 17-7. Tennessee guilty of holding on the play. Memphis State will decline the penalty. Dickey shouting out the play. Tennessee's got Garmin into the game. I don't know that Memphis State sees it. They have no safety man back. Here's the pitch. And the kick is away by Garmin. And it will be rolling downfield to the 33-yard line. And carrying the ball and knocked out of bounds is Hooper. And Garmin was knocked down, but Bill, in watching it, he took a pitch. And in such a situation as that, it's not a true punting formation. And so though he's knocked down, right, he is not
there.
Rough.
Right in there, I think, of course, the blocker came over and tried to pick the man up, and he went over the top. But big play, caught State off guard, and that's what you want to do when you got the quick kick on. It's becoming an old-time defensive struggle now when we're getting into the quick kicking.
And there you see Garmin getting the punt away. He had taken a lateral from Dickey, and on the quick kick, here, long pass Sparkman downfield is intercepted. Kramer!
What a play.
Andre Kramer. Tennessee at the 9-yard line with the interception, the second of the game. Bill Anderson, Andre Kramer. Outstanding athletic play.
Well, he's an outstanding athlete because he's right on his man, but to say he goes up one-handed there, he's got what gets it back in as he falls over the defender. Great play.
The interception by Andre Kramer. There's time out of the field with the score, Tennessee 17, Memphis State. Deep in its own territory, but with the pass interception at least stopping Memphis State. Now the Vols have moved from the 9-yard line, basically on the ground. And carrying the ball that time was Pete Panuska from Brick, New Jersey, through the left side of the line. Tennessee 17, Memphis State 7, and Tennessee just trying to hold on. Panuska back to throw, halfback pass, oh, wide open, intercepted at the 20. Memphis State back to the 30, gets the ball to the 35, and is out of bounds, and a penalty marker is dropping at that point. There you see it in the background. Tennessee had moved with the football from the 9-yard line. And here you see Panuska on what is a third down situation with some 5 yards to go, throwing a pass, and it's simply overthrown. Swanson, he turned, but the ball was already passing over him. Here's the left-hander, Pete Panuska, and the pass. And Bill Swanson just could not, had no chance at all.
Well, of course, he threw the ball a little bit too quick before Swanson could get turned around. But there again, the wind behind him, John, very strong. And that ball, when you have the wind to your back, it tends to float on you. He threw the ball up softly, and that ball will just float on you. And of course, when you're going into the wind, it has a tendency to make a nosedive. You can't keep the nose of the ball up. So that one really flew. Right?
Tennessee leads by 10, but Memphis State, after a 5-yard penalty for a face mask, will have it at the 40-yard line, first down, trailing by 10. Sparkman off play action. Chased by Kimbrough, throws the ball away. Intended for home. The pass is incomplete, and it will become second down and 10. Now, Memphis State has used the timeout. One remaining. Sparkman sends Holmes as a man in motion. He throws. It is complete. Holmes makes the catch. That's enough for the first down. And that will stop the clock. A second look at Danny Sparkman.
Well, he's standing in there, and he's rifling that ball. You can see the nose of it come down, but you have to throw the ball, really put something on it when you're throwing it into the wind to keep the nose up.
First down. State trailing by 10 in Tennessee territory. Sparkman under pressure. Gets it off Harris, 35. Harris down to the 31-yard line.
Harris is a little jitterbug out there. He's a good athlete, great quickness, and you have to watch him. He can break it.
That's the first down on the 13-yard pass and run. Sparkman to Harris. Memphis State moving with the ball at the 30 of Tennessee, trailing by 10. Lots of time left. Sparkman. Womack. Womack moves inside the 25-yard line. 17 carries, 99 yards now for Jeff Womack.
He's been the workhorse of the running game for State all afternoon. He's a good athlete with good strength and very good quickness.
That was Womack. Fisher grabbed at him. Then he's knocked down. Sparkman. It will be second down and 3. Womack cuts inside. I think he's a bit short of the first down. Chris White, number 7. 98, Richard Brown. Tennessee 17, Memphis State 7, but in the second half, Bill, except for one drive after the pass interception by Kramer, it is short of the first down. The Volunteers have had no consistency offensively, and I think you start by crediting the defense of Memphis State.
Well, that's the first place to look, I think. Of course, State's defense has really played well, much better here in the second half than they did in the first half. Just good, sound football.
Memphis State, third down, less than a yard. Sparkman, the quarterback. Sneaking, he's got the first inside the 20.
That's a lot of beef coming off there. You only need a foot. I don't know how it's going to be difficult to stop that.
First down, number 13. This is Womack circling. Womack gets around to the 15, carried out of bounds as he sweeps the left side for 7 yards.
Tennessee's played in pretty good shape. They just Womack has good speed, and he just accelerated and got to the outside on.
So Memphis State trailing by 10. Second and 3. Womack, no, stop. Who's at the bottom? 59, Hovannik. He'll be short of the first down. A couple of Tigers injured on the play. And the clock will be stopped with the injury. Hovannik slides over. 45 is Miller. 7, White. 98, Richard Brown. Tennessee by 10. Memphis State hoping to score. And Womack got a yard on the play. And so it will now be third down and 2 yards to go. The crowd is staying. This one is going right down to that final tick. Sparkman. Third and 1. Womack. I don't think so. Womack got a yard, needed 2. And so here it is. At the Tennessee 10-yard line. Memphis State, fourth down and less than a... That shows you how much. The orange and white Shakers cheering on the defense. The blue and white cheering on Memphis State. Womack, I don't think so again. 77, Cooper. 45, Miller.
Strong defense in there. It's short, I believe.
I think that's Brian Hunt. Yes, 74, Brian Hunt is in there. Ziegler, and it is short. It is not a first down. And Tennessee's defense, which has shut down the opposition without a touchdown for 12 consecutive quarters, comes to play. Well, there you see the swarm.
They brought the 2 offside linemen to lead the play, too. The big offensive linemen in there. Great job of the Tennessee defensive unit to get that stop for you, short of a yard.
So now Tennessee will have the ball at the 10-yard line. Memphis State has scored in this game, but that score came off the defense as the Tennessee punt was blocked and converted into a touchdown by Harkins. Here's Dickey. Using all of the play clock he can. Down to 2 seconds. Handoff. Henderson. Well, he's butted by Fayers, 98. Got a couple of yards. And Memphis State has 1 timeout left. And Dickey again. His eye on the play clock.
Just want to keep it on the ground now and try to eat up as much as the clock as they can. Of course, they need the first down or 2 here.
Banaska wheels off to the left, moving the ball forward. That's a big, big play by Pete Banaska.
Yeah, it really is. He gets a good block there. Good blocking. But then he bounces off with a pretty solid hit and second effort to pick up an extra 3 or 4 yards.
So Pete Banaska moves, and Tennessee will have it third down and 1 at the 19-yard line. Down inside 2 minutes. Dickey, third down short. Henderson, first down, Tennessee.
Big Sam is rolling. He didn't have much running room there, John. He just kept those big legs turning and picked up the necessary yardage for the first down.
260-pound Sam Henderson, and Tennessee has a first down, and that means Tennessee gets another 2 minutes or thereabouts. Memphis State still not using a timeout. Dickey, Tennessee 17, Memphis State 7. Ball at the 24. Henderson grinds out a couple of yards. Shoved back after picking up two. The clock is counting away. Second after second after second. And Tennessee's holding on to the ball. Not much offense in the second half, but just enough when it counted. A first down or two here or there, and Tennessee holds on to win the football game. The final score, Tennessee 17, Memphis State 7. Stay tuned. We'll go to the ball locker room for interviews after this word from your...
Kessling back to the Liberty Bowl with Tennessee head football coach Johnny Majors. And Coach Majors, today, as you expected, a rough physical battle with Memphis State.
Bob, that was one of the toughest football games that I can remember us being involved with in a long time. But we've had no easy ones this year. Memphis State is a real good physical football team. They've got a lot of good football players, and of course, they play their best against us. I'm awfully proud of our team. We gave a great effort. We lost several players in the ball game. We lost Powell, and we lost Davis in the ball game. We had a lot of other people bruised up. They kept coming back, and we stuck in there and made no mistakes except the punt block of any significance. That was a big one, but other than that, we've got the ball game in control pretty much all the way.
Your offensive scheme must have changed a little bit. You lose your top two tailbacks early in the game. Did you shift things around a little bit? And Powell did a great job coming in.
Well, Powell has made some progress. We didn't change a lot. We had to use the ball more on the ground the last quarter because Memphis State was giving us so many different looks. They were disrupting our passing game. And frankly, they gave us every look that we can possibly see in one ball game. We didn't leave our basic thinking, no. We still tried to get the ball to our tailback, and then we did to give the ball more to the fullback in the second half than we have probably all season long.
And I guess a compliment to Powell, too, the fact he didn't fumble. In fact, he didn't turn it over except for the interception.
The one interception, and that was a turnover, but it really probably shouldn't count. The halfback pass looked great all day, and on that one particular play, the safety man stayed back deep, and Panuska didn't see him. And I can't blame him for it. He threw the halfback pass. We thought it was there earlier in the game. That and the punt block were the two turnovers we had. Otherwise, we held on the ball very well. No interceptions by the quarterback and no fumbles by our backs.
And again, second week in a row, your defense holds them out of the end zone.
Oh, great job. And this stand on third and one and fourth and one were just outstanding. When we had our backs to the wall, they rose to the occasion. Our defense is a group that I'm awfully proud of. They gave up no points today. The punt block gave up the 7 points.
How much was the wind a factor in the game? How much did that affect what you tried to do?
Well, frankly, it was blustery. It affects your kicking game and it affects your passing game. Darrell Dickey, I thought, made some terrific plays the first half. We scored coming in the wind here. He made some excellent throws into the wind, and I thought he made some plays that a lot of average people just don't make. So my hat's off to him.
What about now the rest of the schedule? You head down to three crucial SEC games now.
I just hope we can muster enough troops ready to play, but we'll muster one way or the other. Somebody just has to come up and fill the spots, but we are really a battered and bruised football team after the 8 games we've played thus far. But I believe we'll have some guts in us, and we'll take it as it comes Monday and see how we go with our injuries. And I think we'll bounce back and be ready to play, and we'll have to play hard the rest of the way.
Coach Majors, congratulations to you and the team for the victory.
Oh, it was a very fine victory. I'm very proud of their effort.
Tennessee wins over Memphis State. Back to talking with Tennessee players. Eric Swanson caught a touchdown pass in the second quarter. Eric, the offense, except for that second period, really was bogged down. But the second period, you got enough points to win.
Yeah, the offense, we came out kind of slow. You got to give Memphis State credit. Their defense played with a lot of they were aggressive and they had fun playing, and they have a good defense. And I think they earned our respect definitely today. And we just had to execute when we had to, and we got points on the board. So.
Did they come out in some gambling formations that you caught them in for the touchdown passes?
Yeah, I saw them blitz quite a few times from when I was out there. They definitely came after us. They didn't lay back and play our get kind of game. They played their kind of game, and they made things happen. You got to give them credit.
And I guess field position and the wind really played a factor too, didn't it?
Yeah, definitely. The punt team had one block early, but we came back and we executed the kicking game real well. And the offense scored when it had to, and as long as we get those points on the board. That's all we need.
What about your touchdown? How did it happen?
Daryl audibleized at the line there. And actually, I couldn't hear what he said. And I just looked at the defensive back, and he was playing me kind of straight off the ball about 3 yards. And I usually have a choice of going outside or inside, and I felt my chances were better going inside. So I just cut up inside and made a move on him, went inside, and Daryl saw me and hit me with the ball.
It's linebacker Kelly Ziegler, who had an interception and also made the big fourth and one stop to hold Memphis State. Tough battle today, Kelly.
Yeah, I got a lot of respect for Memphis State after this. They played hard. They were a clean team. And, you know, they came to play today, and which, you know, they surprised me.
There was a big physical offensive line, who kept banging at you.
Yeah, they had some big dudes up there, and, you know, they kept coming off the ball and hitting us, and we just had to, you know, put it right back to them.
And I guess the thing, too, the second week in a row you kept them out of the end zone, or an opponent out of the end zone, that's a goal for a defense.
Well, actually, it's the third week in a row, because yeah. Georgia Tech, and they got two field goals. You know, that's the goal of a defense, where I think, you know, we're getting better as a unit every week, and we just got to keep playing hard, you know, and hopefully good things will happen to us.
How much did you play to the wind and the field position today? Were you guys conscious of the wind and the fact that they really couldn't throw into it very well?
Not really. You know, we were just out there. We were getting the reads, you know, the pre-snap reads that we get, their tendencies, and we were just kind of playing off that. You know, I didn't really pay much attention to it.
It's wide receiver Tim McGee. Tim caught a touchdown pass today. Tim, tell us about the offensive performance. This was a rough game, wasn't it?
Well, they basically was very physical, and they were very strong up front, and we had to run the ball because they double-covered me the whole game and tried to mix it up and double all the receivers. And we just took what they gave us, and they gave us the running game. We did excellent with it.
What about the touchdown catch you made? The second period really is the only time you can really move the ball through the air.
Well, it was double coverage again, and I guess our coaches were brave enough to throw it to it. And it was just like I was going to run an out route and let the guy who was playing me inside run, go for the out fake, and he went for it, and I cut right back up the field. And the other guy, there was no way he can get off the hash.
It appeared from upstairs that Memphis State was jumping around and gambling and doing a lot of different looks that maybe you hadn't seen before. Was that true?
They did some things we weren't prepared for, and I think that's why we didn't execute well in the first quarter, and we made some adjustments after first quarter, and it worked out well for us, and we basically just stuck to the game plan, and we did not check to anything, and we just ran right at them.
Next three games are big ones.
Oh, sure is. SEC time. Sugar Bowl.
His running back Jeff Powell. Jeff had to play a lot today because of the injuries to Davis and Wilson. Do you expect to play that much today?
No, I expected to play more than usual, but I didn't expect to play as much as I did. I knew Keith was a little banged up going into the game, so I was ready to play just in case he couldn't go.
You're basically a track guy. That's a lot of physical contact for you, isn't it?
Well, you know, I think a lot of people forget, even though I have run track and I've been successful in track, I played football for a long time. I've played, you know, 2 years of college football already, and I played 10 or 11 years of football. So I'm a football player also, but it's a little rougher out here than it is on the track.
Tennessee wins here in Memphis. Next week, back to play Ole Miss. This is Bob Kessing from Liberty Bowl. John Ward back to wrap things up in just a moment.